Hey everyone, my name is Colin Manco. I'm about to do a video on how to solo all over the fretboard. Try to keep it brief. There's a lot of stuff to cover. I'm going to give you stuff to run with and hopefully be able to expand on. So here we go. I'm going to show you a G major scale, and I'm going to show it to you all over the fretboard, and then sort of talk about how to apply that into some soloing or stuff like that. So if you're not familiar with the major scale, it's used in all Western music. It's important that you know the scale if you want to be good at music. Some people hear stuff, but it's important to sort of, at least from where I come from, to be able to know the scale and manipulate it. There's other scales out there, but this is the jumping off point. So I'm gonna start on the third fret. That's a G of the low E string, and show you from there. So I'm gonna start on my second finger, and just so you know, there's gonna be a lot of it might go a little quick. The cool thing about this video is you can go back and forth and try to figure some of it out if you miss it. So start on your second finger on the low E string to your fourth finger on the low E string. And then first finger. Hopefully you can kind of see what I'm playing. Because if I want to get to all this stuff, I'm gonna have to not talk so much. So hopefully you can see the frets that I'm playing on. So once you memorize that, I mean, you're probably gonna have to come back to this video a whole bunch if this is new stuff to you, and really concentrate on learning this. This is very, very important for being able to solo. So then maybe the next step is, now that you learn the scale, is to start to learn how to play it faster. I mean, it's really basic, and once you start getting into soloing and learning your own licks and all that stuff, it's all about being able to move around these different scales. We're talking about the major scale here, but being able to move around that with no boundaries. You want to be able to make any sort of jump. You want to be able to see this whole scale all over the fretboard and be able to, you know, have no boundaries and be able to start to hear what's going on. So what I like to do is just take intervals, right, and go through the intervals through the scale. So I'm starting to instead of just playing, you know, from note to note, I'm skipping around a little bit. So maybe I'll pick the interval of a third. And if you're not familiar with intervals, they go second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and without getting into too much music theory, you can figure out an interval just by starting on the note that you're starting on or whatever, and counting up, in this case, a third. So one, two, three. So this is our third right here. So now I'll go up the scale in thirds, one to three, and then I'll start on the second part of the scale and go two to four, right, which is another third, and take that interval sequence up the scale. It'll look a little something like this. I'll try to do it slow. My computer. Okay. Right, and then maybe I'll pick a fourth. One, two, three, four. That's my fourth. One. Right, and then maybe I'll pick a fifth. I mean, you could do this stuff all day. It's just it's all about just getting your fingers comfortable for whatever you might want to play. So then all these notes are in the key of G major. If you're playing a song that's in the key of G major, all these notes are going to sound good, with a couple of exceptions, but you'll figure that out hopefully as you go along in your musical journey. Because all these notes are in G major, I mean, this isn't the only place to play these notes. These notes occur all over the fretboard in different sequences, and that's what you have to start figuring out. So if you're going to play it here, you know, why can't you start and play it on the second note, right? So if I'm gonna start play in G major and play it starting off the second note, it's gonna go like this, this, and again, hopefully you can, sort of figure this out on your own. I don't want to talk too much, this video is already pretty long. And, of course, you don't have to play it exactly like that. Some people play like this, just moving the notes around a little bit. Right, and then of course take it up another step, and all the same notes, right? It's just a different place to play it at. And then up here. And up here. Kind of went into G Lydian there for a second, my bad. So that one I messed up. Well, don't worry about it. But right. And maybe I was going a little too fast towards the end there for you to get all those notes. But you know, a lot of it isn't having someone spoon feed this information to you. A lot of this information is stuff that you need to figure out on your own. When you have an idea, you're more likely to remember it if you figure it out on your own. So the important thing about this lesson is learn your major scale. In this case, we're talking about the G major scale, and learn it all over the fretboard. Figure out what notes they are, and if you can't figure out the notes, figure out by sound. Just up the fretboard, you know, and so anytime you're playing a song in the key of G major, you know, you got all that stuff to call on, and play them in different intervals. Maybe at another interval, maybe I want to play a third and a third and a second all the way up the fretboard. Once I know all those scales, I can just be like, right? I messed up. I'm playing G Lydian there, because I'm thinking, when I think major, I usually think of the sharp four, or maybe like an arpeggio, like, I'll go up a third and then down in two thirds. Mixed Lydian there for a second. I just came up with that just a second ago. Like, I mean, I've never run that particular sequence up that scale before. It's just because I know the scale so well that I can start to branch out on it, and eventually you're just able to pick an interval sequence and just play it. And that's sort of the goal you want to strive for. And the cool thing about this scale is it's a G major scale if I start on G. However, if I start on A and play that major scale, the first one I showed you, right? And then move every other scale we learned that's a part of that a part of the G major scale up as much as you moved the first scale we learned. I don't know if that makes any sense. You have you know, this whole other scale you play. So if the song's in a different key, like not in the key of G, for example, you know, you can solo, or you know, you have all the notes in that key available to you. So you know, learn these scales, and there's a million more of them, and I mean, it's really endless. Like it's so hard to like give a good tutorial on this. Hopefully, some of this sparked your imagination more so than gave you cool stuff to play. It's not about the cool stuff to play. It's about well, eventually it is. But it's about knowing what it takes to get better at what you do. And hopefully I didn't mess up too much. But anyways, hope this helped, and take it easy. Vote for me. I'd love to have a new guitar. So keep it real.